Hi everyone, today we are going to see about normal dental floating. We should know good dental health is vital to the horse's overall well-being. Good dental health is essential for the proper functioning of horse digestive system because digestion is a complex process that begins with chewing. If the food is not chewed properly, it will not digest properly and could lead to chronic colic, poor absorption of essential nutrients, etc. Routine dental examinations should be done at every 6 months to 1 year interval, or some of the signs will indicate the need of dental examination. First is quitting, that is dropping of feet from mouth while eating, then suddenly not interested in eating or finishing the meals, losing the weight for no apparent reason, tossing or tilting the head, poor performance and bad smell or discharge from mouth. These are some signs that indicates the need for dental examination. Now we are going to examine a horse and do a normal dental floating. Actually, floating was a term that originated from carpentry profession to describe leveling or smoothening. First, sedate the animal because not all the animals will allow to put mouth speculum. During floating also, there will be noise. So to relieve the anxiety and to keep the animal calm, better we should sedate. This is equine full mouth speculum. It has incisor plates to accommodate incisors and safety ratchets that allows you a good opening of mouth with maximum safety. Now let us apply the speculum. First, place the incisors over the incisor plate. Then tight the belt. Now open the speculum. So when you open it, it will be locked by the ratchets. After applying the speculum, clean the mouth with antiseptics added water, because there may be any feed material or grass. So if we clean the mouth properly, we can visualize the mouth properly. Now examine the teeth. We should look for loose teeth, sharp edges, cranial and caudal hooks, dental caps or any other abnormalities. In old horses or the horses those have not undergone dentistry for long time, you can find cranial and caudal hooks. The cranial hook will be seen in upper premolar and the caudal hook will be seen in the last lower molar. So we have to remove all the sharp edges unless it will injure the adjacent soft tissues. This is a modern motorized Swiss floss. This is a most practical and versatile instrument. This float has diamond disc. This gives you a coarse grinding tooth surface. It takes less time to perform, so heat production is less. One more disc is there, that is carbide disc. This has finer grinding property resulting in smooth surface. It takes more time, so it produces heat during the process. In equines, upper jaw is wider than the lower jaw and due to the continuous mastication and age advancement, there will be sharp molar edges in the outside border of upper molars and the inside border of lower molars. So we'll start floating now. You can put your hand also inside and palpate the sharp edges. We can call this procedure as dental prophylaxis or dental floating. It involves an oral examination and routine dental maintenance procedure like reduction of sharp enamel points, reduction of small crown projections like hook, beaks and small waves and ridges, and never remove more than 3 to 4 mm of occlusal surface at a time because the pulp cavity may expose. See, this is how the float makes noise. This is called dental caps. At 2.5 years to 5 years of age, the horse may have dental caps. These are nothing but deciduous teeth. During the eruption of permanent teeth, the temporary teeth are pushed out, but some temporary teeth will be attached and fails to fall. So this attached tooth will interfere in the mastication process. So with the cap remover, we can remove that. After the procedure also, you should wash the mouth with antiseptic mixed water to remove the dental dust. Equally apply the pressure on both sides and close the speculum. This is incisor mouth gap. This is to examine the incisors, just made up of two PVC pipes. First, I want to add some information. Unlike other species, each equine tooth has unique number. The right upper will start with 10, the left upper will start with 20, and the left lower will start with 30, and the right lower will start with 40. You see, the right upper incisors are numbered as 101, 102, 103, and the canine 104. The first premolar, that is wolf teeth, is 105. Like that, it goes up to 111. This is just to make everyone to understand that which tooth is affected. I hope you got some knowledge in equine dentistry. Please subscribe the channel and share if you like the video. Thank you.